Let's go back to Jackie Pascual for details on the ECCP's meeting with the Tourism Department. Jackie?
Hi, Denise. The Tourism Department is confident of hitting its target of 4.8 million tourist arrivals this year as the agency plans to further improve tourism services in the country. At a forum organized by the European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines in Makati, Tourism Undersecretary Shireen Yu Pamintuan said that as of September 19, 2023, yesterday, they have recorded around 3.8 million arrivals for the year, just 1 million more to go to hit the target. She is optimistic of even breaching the target because of the upcoming holiday season, and she mentioned that they may breach the target of 4.8 million. She also unveiled several plans of the DOT, like the setting up of emergency bay watch facilities in top beach destinations in the country. She noted that even Boracay, which is one of the world's best beaches, has no emergency facilities such as emergency doctors and other medical services. And now DOT is in talks with the health department and the Tourism Infrastructure and Enterprise Zone Authority for this project. The DOT will also soon launch a 24/7 tourism hotline for all tourist-related concerns. Some call center agents, she said, will be able to speak a foreign language like Chinese or Korean to address the concerns of the tourists. Yu Pamintuan also added that the DOT will continue the Love the Philippines slogan amid initial controversies. She said they have published terms of references for the bidding or procurement of ads and marketing campaigns worth 700 million pesos. And that's the latest from Makati. Denise, back to you.
Thanks, Jackie. There remains to be a gap in the supply and demand for Filipino talents in the IT BPM industry. According to Jack Madrid, president and CEO of IBPAP, the umbrella organization of the industry, there's an unceasing demand for Filipino workers in the sector, but the problem lies in attracting qualified talents. The group is now working with several government agencies to help plug this gap and modernize the skills of students.
The job requirements of our industry are becoming more demanding. They are becoming more diverse. It is no longer a one-dimensional customer service voice-based phone call. Our industry has matured and diversified into a more diverse set of industry verticals. Lots of work to be done. We have identified the skills needed for the next 5 years. We have communicated that, and now where the rubber meets the road will really be to execute and make sure that we unlock those scholarship funds and convince our partners in government to move even faster than they have before.
The U.S. visa waiver program with the Philippines' flagship carrier has been put on hold. In a statement, Philippine Airlines says it is now unable to fly non-immigrant passengers to the U.S. who are traveling under the visa waiver program. It said the airline's agreement for this travel privilege with the U.S. government has expired, and it is working with the U.S. Customs Border Protection for renewal. PAL, however, said most of its passengers, notably those with valid U.S. visas or are U.S. citizens or residents, are not affected and may still travel on flights to the United States. Under the visa waiver program, eligible citizens of 40 participating countries can visit the U.S. for up to 90 days without securing a visa as long as they have a valid travel authorization. Time for some local corporate stories. Metro Pacific Investments' delisting push is moving forward. It says at the end of the tender offer period on September 19th, around 5.4 billion common shares were tendered. This represents around 19% of MPIC's total issued and outstanding listed shares. MPIC says the total tendered shares has exceeded the threshold required to complete its voluntary delisting. Meanwhile, real estate giant Megaworld set to build its fifth residential condominium inside its 34-hectare township in Bacolod City. The 26-story Kensington Sky Garden is expected to be the tallest residential development in Visayas. It is scheduled for completion in 2029. Megaworld aims to generate around 5 billion pesos in sales from this new property. And finally, Century Pacific Food Philippines now distributing its plant-based product Unmeat in Australia. It has entered Australia's largest supermarket chain, Woolworths, as plant-based consumption there gained traction, with one in three Australians consciously reducing meat consumption.
A report by the United Nations shows an alarming state of the digital landscape in the Philippines. It says the Philippines ranks first in digital illiteracy and second in online sexual exploitation of children. Ara Perez tells us how government plans to address the problem.
Exploitation of children. The country, according to a United Nations study, is also a hotbed of online scamming. The Cybercrime Investigation and Coordinating Center says these are some of the challenges the agency is trying to overcome during its budget hearing at the Senate. It's an unflattering situation for the Philippines, which the center wants to change.
Ibig sabihin po niyan, yung mga magulang at child, imagine yung Pasay raid. There are four floors, 10 rooms, times 30 people inside na nagsascamming, 300 per floor, times four floors, 1,200, three shifts. Ilang buildings ang ina-assume nila may ganyan ng Pilipinas, mga 200 more. Talagang hotbed for online scamming ang Pilipinas.
When asked by senators why the country is becoming a hub for cybercrimes, the Department of Information and Communications Technology cited several factors. But one huge reason is they lack essential equipment.
One of the reasons is, of course, poverty, no? But primarily po, in terms of cybersecurity, we lack the necessary tools in order to identify the perpetrators of these crimes and to track them. We in the executive session will explain how we should be doing it. In many other countries, they have already those tools in order to identify malicious content and be able to do preemptive measures.
According to the CICC, related government agencies are working together to keep pace with the threats. The CICC has a 326 million peso allocation under the 2024 National Expenditure Program, and it is asking for additional funding for technical tools and subscriptions to competently discharge their duties. Their parent agency, DICT, is also requesting an augmentation after GRACEPO immediately called them out for their 25% utilization rate in their 13 billion peso budget this year.
Utilization rate, yung baba-baba naman. Tapos hingi kayo ng additional budget. I mean, you're trying to tell this panel that by the end of this year, you will have been able to utilize about 70%, more or less, of your budget. But right now, we're already in the bare months. How are you able to do that? Ayan, last minute, magkakram kayo para magbayad na lang.
The budget hearing also revealed that in the eyes of other countries, the Philippines is considered illiterate in the digital world.
Again, the Philippines is in the lowest basic digital skills. Is this accurate? Of 6% of those age 15 and above, only have basic internet skills. Sa sexual exploitation, mataas tayo. Tapos sa attacks, tayo rin ang ina-attack. Tapos sa literacy, tayo number one sa pinaka-illiterate digitally. That's really painful and we must do something. This goes hand in hand with learning poverty.
Yes, it is an accurate report from the United Nations. But let me qualify, Your Honor, that that report was actually the last time that they asked for that report was 2019. So now it's being updated, and I am particularly confident that we have increased our basic literacy and our intermediate or average literacy.
In the meantime, the DICT had this advice to the public to avoid scammers.
Unang-una po, wag kayong mag-click sa pinadala sa inyo. Kung bangko po allegedly ang kumontak, huwag niyo pong i-click yung pinadala sa inyo. Pumunta ka po doon sa alam mong legitimate na site ng bangko mo. Huwag po doon sa pinadala sa iyo. Number two po, meron po kaming acronym BIRD. So you block, you ignore, then you report, and then you delete the message. Huwag din po kayong sasagot.
Senators and DICT officials held an executive session to discuss some security concerns, including the requested confidential funds. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government's chief economist echoing the warning of Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno that suspending taxes on fuel will only do more harm than good. Calls are growing for government to suspend the VAT and excise taxes on petroleum products to ease the burden from soaring fuel prices. But National Economic Development Chief Arsenio Balisacan says doing so would only hurt the poor.
It's quite inequitable. It's quite a risk to our fiscal program. There are better ways of protecting the poor and vulnerable. We would rather have the targeted assistance program for the poor, for jeepney drivers, tricycle drivers, than having a universal subsidy that tends to benefits disproportionately the rich.